What's good, y'all? It's your boy, the Waffle Chief, and we back with another predictions video. This time, we got Crown Jewel. Now, while the matches on the card look pretty interesting, overall, this is a filler. Okay, we all know how fillers go. You want to skip them, and most of the time you can, but sometimes there's good filler. Like a Bleach Beach Day episode. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Okay? Everybody's there for a good time. Chilling on the sand. It's kind of like Crown Jewel. This card looks like a good time. Saudi Arabia, their sand. It is like the Bleach episode. Except there won't be a whole lot of that one thing. Alright?
Nana!
But let's get into the card. So we got Liv Morgan and Nia Jax for the Crown Jewel Championship, whatever the fuck it's called. Alright, Tiffany Stratton could cash in, but I don't really see that happening here. If she were to cash in, would she win both titles? Would she be champion, double champion, crown champion, triple crown, whatever? I don't know what would happen, but I don't really see that happening yet. I think they're going to stretch it out over time. Y'all know how Triple H books his stories. Everything's very long and deliberate and tedious. Now, who's going to win this match? I mean, on paper, Nia Jax should beat the shit out of Liv Morgan. But I think Liv Morgan going to find some kind of sneaky way to get the victory. Rhea Ripley's injured again. That's very unfortunate. It seems like she'll be out till the Rumble and she'll return there. And they're really going to stretch Liv and Rhea out to a WrestleMania. Me, personally, I'm done with the feud, to be honest. They've made Liv Morgan look so weak over time. Judgment Day looked like some geeks, as some people would call them. You know, they just look terrible. I've lost all interest. Honestly, just slap the belt on Io Sky. I mean, she's killing it right now. I just give it to her. You could do Rhea and Io at WrestleMania. And have Rhea and Liv wrap up sometime during Chamber or something like that. The match don't scream WrestleMania to me. They booked Rhea too strong and they booked Liv too weak. But moving on, Liv Morgan's winning this match. Okay. And then I believe there's a triple threat match between LA Knight, Carmelo Hayes, and Andrade for the United States Championship. If I were booking it, right, I feel like Carmelo Hayes should win the U.S. title here. Andrade should beat Carmelo for it later down the line. And there's been talks of a feud between Carmelo and AJ Styles. I personally like to see that. LA Knight's had a good run with the belt. He's had many solid title defenses. When he cost both of them the match, the Game 7 match, and there was no winner, it was kind of weirdly cowardly, like out of a babyface element. I don't understand the decision behind that. Kind of makes LA Knight look like a coward. Like he didn't want to face any of them. But now he ended up facing both of them. So I think Carmelo Hayes should win. I think it's a good chance he might. You know, that's my prediction. Let's have some fun. Carmelo Hayes is going to win the U.S. title. Then we have the Fatal 4-Way Tag Match for the Women's Tag Titles. Now, I'm going to be honest with you. I really don't care about this. I'm sorry. Jade and Bianca have been floating on this insignificant tag title run. Nothing has really come of it. And I'm kind of ready for them to be single stars. As I am with Io as well, I'm ready for her to be a single star again. So, maybe you can give it to Lash and Chikara. I don't know. But most likely, Bianca and Jay is going to retain again. Moving on, we got Randy Orton and Kevin Owens. Now, this match is going to be incredible. The way they built it up on SmackDown last week, fantastic. Triple H really portrayed Kevin Owens as this killer, this murderer, almost Kevin Steen-like. So, Randy Orton is going to have his hands full. Kevin Owens unhinged. He might start doing power bombs on the apron again. I don't know what's going to happen. I think Randy's going to get badly hurt. Leads to Kevin Owens and Cody Rhodes at Survivor Series. So I got Kevin Owens winning this match by violent fashion. Violent. Another blood feud that's been brewing up pretty nicely. Seth Rollins and Bronson Reed. When Bronson Reed hit them 7 tsunamis, and I don't know if it was 6, 7, it don't matter. It was incredible. It was a star-making performance. Bronson Reed has been pushed consistently at the top of the card for the past 2 months on Monday Night Raw. He wants his spot at the top. He called his shot against Seth Rollins, former world heavyweight champion, multi-time world champ. Bronson Reed calls his shot. I think he gets the job done. They crown Jewel. I think that's the right way to go, personally. Seth Rollins does not need to win this match. He's got a big match coming up. We see CM Punk down the road. Bronson needs way more. Give it to Bronson Reed, and I'd give it to him in dominant fashion. We got to continue that star-making build. This is how you build new stars and make them credible. Beat established guys. Now, I don't know what the main event's going to be, but most likely it's going to be what I think it is. So, the semi-last match will be Cody Rhodes and Gunther for the Crown Jewel Championship. Even though the match is going to be fire and it probably should be the main event, but I don't know. I really don't know who's going to win this match. It's super unpredictable. I could see Kevin Owens maybe costing Cody Rhodes the match later on. So, I'm going to go with Gunther. And then what probably is going to be the main event, Roman Reigns, the Usos, against Solo, Jacob. And is it Tama, is it Tonga, or is it 3-on-4? I don't really know. Okay, now, War Games is next month. You have to get to War Games. You cannot have Roman and them win right now. They have to get their ass beat in this match. It just has to happen. Solo's team is going to win. And they're going to get beat down so badly that Sami Zayn, he's going to be conflicted. He's not going to know what to do because he kind of talked with Solo and Jay and Jimmy. He's really in the middle. He really wants nothing to do with it. So he's going to be in that tough spot. Roman's going to be like, man, I'm going to have to come clean, Sami. We need more help. That's how his character is going to develop. Roman losing develops his character more, and he gets you closer to War Games. It wouldn't make any sense for them to win here. So, I got Solo's team winning. That's about it for Crown Jewel. Should be a fun afternoon of professional wrestling. I can't believe this card is more than 5 matches. Triple H really be reading Twitter. They was not lying about that. Let me know what y'all think in the comments. I'll try to post reactions this week. The copyright stuff can get kind of wonky. But until next time, folks, please like and subscribe.